Hello everyone, welcome back to Mr. Random Generator. In this video, I will be showing you a module named Chalk. So what is it? Well, Chalk is an NPM module that enables us to colorize and stylize our debugging statements that we see in our console. So why do we need that? Well, imagine a situation where you want to debug a project and you put some console.log statements here and there. So if you build that project, the chances are you will see thousands of lines of debugging statements into your console. So finding the specific ones throughout your terminal is actually really difficult thing to do. So Chalk is really a helpful tool for us developers to use it in order to solve that issue basically. So how do we use that? As you can see, I have a Visual Studio code open right there with an empty directory named Chalk. So the first thing I want to do is initialize our project like so. Then what we need to do is install Chalk. Now it's installed. What we can do is create a JavaScript file, and inside our JavaScript file we can import the Chalk like so. So using the Chalk is actually really simple. What you can do is use your ordinary logging statements, and inside your logging statements you can specify the Chalk instances by naming it Chalk dot, let's say I want to make my message green, and inside that I can put my statement. Let's say everything was going fine until. So I want to make my until word underlined and orange. So as you can see, if I type orange, it says to me that the orange is not existing inside the Chalk. So what I can do is I can give the RGB values, or I can give the hex values. So let's stick with hex and give an orange value of, let's say, EE8800. And after that, I can specify the underlining feature by typing it underline, and then I can give my message, which is until. And after that, I can also concatenate an error message. As for our error message, I want that to be black, and it should have a red background. So first I mention the foreground color, which is black. Let's type in black. Then inside that I can give chalk.bg, stands for background, red, and inside that I can give my error message, which is an error occurred. So let's save it and run it. As you can see, it is working properly. Obviously, you can do much more stuff than that. Let's say I want to use a variable named FPS, which is 144. So using that is actually really simple. Again, we put console.log, and inside that we can type Chalk and put our two quotes, and inside that we can actually type in FPS to basically not color the initial statement, but after that. So you will get what I want to say in a minute. So we put FPS there. So after that we can put, let's say, this, and we specify the color name, which is red, and then I pass my variable as usual like so. And if I run that, what I should see is the white FPS followed by a red 144. So let's test that out. As you can see, it is working properly. One important thing to mention here is that if you put a space between the curly brace and red, it won't work. As you can see, we get an error message. So you need to be careful while using that. So I think now you'll get the basics. So now let's do something bit more interesting, shall we? So let's delete those and install a new module named log updates. So npm install log updates. What that module enables us to do is we can update our logging statements without actually printing another statement on top of it. So imagine a loading bar type of situation. So let's import that in our project by log update require, and let's mention log update. Yeah, just like that. And after that, let's define an array of output, let's say outputs, that has chalk elements, chalk logging statements of, let's say, let's make it red of buzz and blue of fizz. The classical fizz buzz. Then define a switch, let's say make it zero, and after that open up an interval and pass a basic function inside that, like so. And inside our function, what we want to do is we just want to create a basic flip-flop type of switch. So if this our switch variable is equal to zero, what we want to do is make it into one. So let's make it into one, like so. And if that is not the case, we just want it to be zero again. After that, this is where we should be using our module log update, and inside that we should give our array with the switch index. Yeah, that would be fine. So if we run that, oh, actually before we run that, we obviously need to give our timeouts. So 1 second for timeout should be good. So if I run that, what we should be seeing is fizz and buzz continuously updating in our terminal. So let's look at that if it is the case. And as you can see, every second it updates to fizz, buzz, and continues on like that. So that is basically it for the video. This is an introduction to basically chalk and log update modules. So hope you like it. If that is the case, please make sure to hit the like button and consider subscribing. See you next time. Take care.